The semiconductor industry is booming, with businesses like Nvidia and Qualcomm dominating the market. Semiconductors are used everywhere, in phones, laptops, and TVs. However, you may not realize it, but semiconductors also make up a critical component in your car. Nvidia work with Mercedes and Volvo, and Qualcomm with BMW to make sure cars run smoothly and effectively as computers on wheels, with the market for semiconductors in cars expected to triple by 2030. One of the most important and highly valued companies that you've probably never heard of is Mobileye, a business that designs ADAS or Advanced Driver Assistance systems, who have revolutionized smart vehicles and safety features like lane guidance and emergency braking. But what is Mobileye and how were they founded? Here's how it happened. First of all, what is Mobileye? Well, Mobileye are computer vision experts who create ADAS technology through a chip they call IQ, which they first introduced in 2004 but has since been integrated into over 100 million vehicles. IQ being a super smart and super efficient chip that provides mobility solutions alongside a small windscreen mounted camera. Mobileye create warnings in cars for lane departures, forward collisions, low speed urban collisions, as well as intelligent headlamps and speed limit recognition, among many other things. Think of all the smart features your new car has, and they've probably been thought up or integrated by Mobileye. Their ADAS technology is currently used by over 30 different car manufacturers. And whilst Mobileye is known for its single camera technology, it also uses LiDAR on their road experience management system that uses Mobileye equipped vehicles to collect data from the road and send it to the cloud, which automatically creates a map of the world. This is cost-effective for the business, but a little scary when you think that these cameras follow you everywhere. These maps are then used by the likes of Udel and Transdev for their autonomous delivery vehicles. Clever. But the ingenuity doesn't stop there, as Mobileye want to create their own robo-taxis, a project they're running in Germany where they plan to deploy 50 vehicles in Munich, taking advantage of the government's decision to legalize autonomous vehicles in Germany. Now we know what Mobileye is, what is it used for? Well, all these smart gadgets are used to understand what surrounds the vehicle, where other people are, animals, traffic lights, and the list goes on. Knowing this can help with emergency braking should an accident be predicted, which can help to prevent unnecessary injuries or collisions. Mobileye use just a single video camera, therefore offering a much cheaper service than their competitors, making it easier for the product to scale. But where does their story start? Most people think that technological innovations like this would come from Silicon Valley or at least the US. Well, Mobileye is slightly different. The firm was founded by Amnon Shashua and Ziv Avaram in Jerusalem in 1999, when Shashua studied at the Hebrew University. His research was able to detect vehicles using a camera and software algorithms. After receiving funding from an Asian investor, Shashua brought on board his close friend Ziv Avaram as co-founder, with Shashua responsible for tech, R&D and strategic vision, with Avaram responsible for operations, finance and investor relations. When Mobileye thought about long-term strategy, they realized they had to design a full system on a chip which housed the computational load of the computer vision stack. None of their competitors were doing both hardware and software at the same time, a radical but critical decision for Mobileye's leadership. To help achieve this strategic vision, they hired Elchanan Rushenek to lead Mobileye's SoC design team, and he built the first iteration of IQ in 2004. As of today, 5 generations and 100 million chips later, Rushenek still continues his work with the business. When Mobileye was originally started, ADAS was in its infancy, and the general view was that radar sensors or LiDAR was required, needing at least 2 cameras or stereo vision. But Shashua pushed on with his belief that a single camera mounted on the windscreen or monovision could perform critical safety functions like automatic emergency braking. This meant that costs were half compared to competitors, making Mobileye more aligned to the mass market, able to scale faster. They then realized in 2013 that they could be pioneers in AV technology and hired Shalev Schwartz as the CTO of Mobileye, position that he still holds to this day. A year later, and the founders took Mobileye public on the New York Stock Exchange at a valuation of $5.3 billion. Just a few years later, however, in 2017, life changed for Mobileye when they were acquired by Intel in 2017 for $15.3 billion. Intel had been losing market share when it came to semiconductors, with the likes of Qualcomm seen as a major competitor. The acquisition was therefore meant to be a unique opportunity to get in at the bottom of the self-driving vehicle market, which they described as computers on wheels. Since the acquisition, Mobileye has continued to grow, increasing staff from 750 to almost 3,000, as well as growing revenues from $350 million in 2016 to $1 billion by the end of 2020. Their robo-taxi experiment is due to launch in Tel Aviv and Munich this year, and Mobileye have now built a fully autonomous vehicle that drives using 11 cameras, which they've named SuperVision. Mobileye has therefore gone from revolutionizing ADAS to expanding into AV to offer basic and complex driver assists in a bid to make roads safer and smarter. For Intel, you'd think this was mission accomplished. However, Intel are not so happy, and are now looking to relist Mobileye, seemingly hoping to get their money back in the public markets with a valuation close to $15 billion after their acquisition 4 years ago has not produced the success it had first hoped for. The frothy markets that have led to sky-high valuations of many high-growth businesses means it's now the perfect time to relist. This shouldn't be a problem for Mobileye, which already operates quite distinctly from the rest of Intel, and Intel will remain a majority shareholder anyway. Intel see the acquisition as a success given that Mobileye's revenues were up 40% year-on-year, with Intel using the IPO to unlock value for shareholders, according to Pat Gelsinger, the Intel CEO. And with the IPO, investors can now get direct exposure to the AV world, whereas the likes of Waymo and Cruise sit within Google and GM, respectively. It's not the first time Mobileye have been involved in disruptive circumstances, as Tesla severed ties with the business after a fatal accident in 2016. With Tesla blaming the technology that apparently couldn't distinguish between a truck and the sky behind it, with deadly consequences. The IPO disruption, however, hasn't affected Mobileye. They plan to continue expanding their capabilities to offer solutions to more complex road situations like junctions and cities. But they're perhaps battling the stigma that comes with the EV/AV industry, where overpromise and underdeliver seems commonplace. But the fact that Mobileye have implemented their technology into more than 100 million cars to date makes them an industry leader, with almost all brands relying on Mobileye one way or another. With a total addressable market for automotive semiconductors expected to grow from $50 billion in 2021 to $115 billion in 2030, the market is massive and the opportunities are almost endless. And that's how it happened.